Is it good to be alive on a Monday night in Hartford, Connecticut, or what? My apologies for showing up a little bit late. I've had a weekend. I got locked inside headquarters in Stamford, and by the time I got out, which was just a few short hours ago, it dawned on me that we were in the XL Center. So I drove straight here to be with you beautiful maniacs. I also drove here to get into a fight with Drew McIntyre, but apparently he has left the building. So, Pat McAfee, last week, you recall, I said, just to get under Drew's skin as he sat in the cheap seats, I said, I can do my business in a shorter amount of time than he was world heavyweight champion, which is 5 minutes and 46 seconds, right?
Bingo.
Not that I'm trying to make that a thing or anything, but 5 minutes, 46 seconds. Since I came to pick a fight, and since he left, this is not going to be a popular decision, but what if today we go overtime? What if I stay here long enough for Drew to come back? Because you know, he's at a red light right now. He just left. And you know he's not texting his wife. He's scrolling through Twitter. So please, get your phones out. Take your pictures. You too, Pat.
Yep, gotcha. I'm going to do it. Yep.
Tweet at him right now that I am live and in living color right here.
Hey.
And if he's not a coward, and I know that's a big ask, if Drew McIntyre is not a coward, he will turn around and he will come back to this building and in this ring on top of the ice that Gordie Howe skated on for the Hartford Whalers. He can catch the beating that he deserves.
Are you really tweeting?
Yeah, I just tweeted him right now. Service isn't as great in Hartford as you would hope for this type of situation, but
I mean what I say, ladies and gentlemen. I will hold this show hostage. So I would ask you guys what you want to talk about to kill some time, but that's somebody else's deal. So, I'll ask you this. Can I tell you a story? All right. It's a little bit of a recap, if you will. Back in January, inside the Royal Rumble, Drew McIntyre DDT'd me so hard that I posted my arm to prevent the brunt of the damage going to my neck, and I tore my tricep off the bone. And I was heartbroken. You were too, thank you. I thought Drew ruined my WrestleMania dreams. But I had a good cry about it. I had a great surgery. I picked myself back up and I realized that Drew McIntyre didn't ruin anything. If anything, he postponed my WrestleMania dreams. Maybe delayed is a better word. Because in baseball, they call me a five-tool player. I can do everything. I can do commentary, and that's what I did at WrestleMania. Five-tool player, Drew McIntyre, just a tool.
Oh. Oh.
And we're waiting. For weeks that turn into months, I have to tune into this show that I was excited to be back on and listen to this guy run his mouth about how he prayed for me to be injured and he's proud that I'm injured. But he prayed for this. He picked a fight. He picked a very personal fight with the pettiest man on the roster. Maybe even on Earth. And I said last week I was going to make his life a living hell. That's exactly what I plan on doing. But his bitching and complaining went from I injured CM Punk to CM Punk ruined my WrestleMania plans. CM Punk ruined my title aspirations. CM Punk broke my elbow. He's a hater. He hates the way I look. He hates the way I walk. He hates the way I talk. But when I tune in, all he does is talk about me. All he does is sit in the ring like me. All he does is try to speak like me. He tries to be me, and it dawned on me that Drew McIntyre, do you hate me or do you hate yourself? Ooh. Because you're a choke artist, not like how I'm a choke artist, Pat. Two very different things.
Guillotine, yeah.
Drew McIntyre prayed for this. I am the unforgiving consequences to his actions. Drew, you prayed for this, and I broke your elbow. And if you show up now, or the next time I see you, I'm gonna break your face. And then I'm gonna break your heart. And all this praying you do, I don't know if you're a God-fearing man, but the fact that you haven't showed up yet tells me that there is one thing that you fear. One name, three syllables, C.M.
Hell yeah.
If you make me go to Glasgow, Scotland, I'm gonna be hiding in a bowl of haggis, and I'm gonna pop out, and I'm gonna break your face.
Damn, Punk continues to live in Drew McIntyre's head.
Drew might have got stuck in traffic. He might not have seen it. But in CM Punk's eyes, the Scottish Warrior no-showed him tonight in Hartford.